All praises to Yahweh Bahasham Yahweh Shai, Bahasham Rakakadash. Double honors to the elders and the apostles of Great Millstone. And salutations to all the true sincere brethren around the four corners, pushing out this purified truth, cleansing this wicked defiled kingdom with the word, and the water to Yahweh Shai, because without him, none of this would even be possible. Salutation as well to the rest of the brothers and sisters out there who believe. I forgot to mention that, okay? Of Judah have dealt very treacherously against me, saith the Lord. So the house of Israel, being the northern kingdom, okay, and then the house of Judah, starting with Judah, but also Benjamin and Levi, have dealt very treacherously against the Lord. Israel, the 12 tribes of Israel, have constantly proven that we are a rebellious, hard-headed, stiff-necked nation, okay? And in the scriptures, it pinpoints how Israel would be full circle, through and through. So it's sad to say, but based off of the wickedness of our people and how we are, shows that we are the Israelites, man. Because our whole nation have dealt treacherously against the Lord, have pretty much put off his ways. The northern and the southern kingdom, okay? Let's go back to that. This is Jeremiah 5 and 11. For the house of Israel and the house of Judah have dealt very treacherously against me, saith the Lord. So the Lord's people are hard-headed. They're rebellious. So imagine you being a father and you having children that don't listen to you. It will piss you off, man. So it got to the point where he just put curses on you. And now you don't thrive very well. We're in the lowest conditions in these communities. All right? And it's funny because two-thirds of Israel find this truth to be a joke. But they don't realize the Lord is mocking them based off of the curses that they go through. These women are miserable. Men are miserable. And they don't even know why. But it all goes back to the Lord putting curses on our people, man. Okay, because our people have dealt treacherously against the Lord. They have belied the Lord and said, it is not he. Neither shall evil come upon us, neither shall we see sword nor famine. So the men of the Lord, we come out here and we tell you, certain things are going to happen. A great sword is coming. Famine is coming. So much evil is coming that when we try to bring it to you through word, it doesn't even feel like it's enough. We can't really put it in words, the great evil that's coming to America, man. Okay? But two-thirds of our people, they believe none of these things are going to happen. No judgment is going to happen. The Lord is going to always allow Israel to just be wicked and rebellious. And that's as far as the story goes. But Yahweh is a man of judgment. And being a man of judgment, he has to bring judgment to the wicked of our people. Okay? Which is coming soon. I'll start with 11 and read down to 12. For the house of Israel and the house of Judah, which goes for all the 12 tribes, have dealt very treacherously against me, saith the Lord. I want to pull out that word treacherously in the blue letter. Give me a second here. verses Jeremiah 5 and 11 and the word treacherously in Hebrews 8:98, it says, by God, to act treacherously, deceitfully, deal treacherously, to act or deal treacherously, faithlessly, deceitfully, offend. So, two-thirds of our people offend the Lord. Two-thirds of our people deal deceitfully with the Lord, okay? You have our people, they may hear the truth, and they come unto us as if they're our people. But really within their minds, their hearts are nowhere close to Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shah. Because once they walk off, they act like they never heard it. So our people deal deceitfully, man. Our people rob each other, kill each other through deceit, through money, because money is not a problem. But when you love money, then it becomes a problem. A lot of people who are involved in gangs or involved in some kind of drug dealing is all for money, man. Okay? Because our people are very, very inspired when it comes to evil. They even deal evil towards our Lord, man, the one who created us. The one who called us to be the greatest nation of people on earth, we're deceitful to him. You know, that shows how messed up we are as a people, man. You know, you gotta imagine how brokenhearted our Lord is at this present time, seeing how the people he made don't even respect him. They just reject him and act as if he does not exist. Okay? House of Israel and the house of Judah have dealt very treacherously against me. So deceitful, just rebellious, man. Offending the Lord constantly. They have belied the Lord. So going into that word belied in the blue letter, Hebrews 35 and 84, it says, kakash, to deceive, lie, fail, grow lean, be disappointed, be untrue, be insufficient, be found liars, be lied, deny, dissemble, deal falsely. So going into being deceitful. Our people are deceitful, man. Okay? Our people claim to love the Lord, but they show in so many ways that they despise the Lord. The Lord has laid out his ways, and Israel just stomps all over it, walks all over it like it doesn't exist, man. And that's why Yahweh Ba'ashem Yahweh Shai has to do something. He has to bring judgment, because you people do not take him seriously, man. Okay, so he's going to have to force you to take him seriously. But before he does that, he's sending out his prophets for you people to get the message so you can be warned before things happen. Okay? They have belied the Lord and said, it is not he, neither shall evil come upon us, neither shall we see sword nor famine. Two-thirds believe the Lord will never judge them. Two-thirds of our people believe within their wickedness, they are going to be justified. Because judgment, matter of fact, let me just pull it out. Ecclesiastes 8 and 11. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily, therefore the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil. So our people don't really think famine and sword is coming, because judgment doesn't always happen swiftly. The Lord may not always strike you right away for something that you did that was wrong, man. The Lord is so patient that he'll allow you to get away with certain things It didn't hit you in your next life, man. But you went your whole life thinking, okay, you got away with it, and everything is okay. But then your next life come around, and the Lord shows you, bow, I got you, man. And you didn't even expect it. I got you for something you did 400, 500 years ago, man. Okay? So because sentence against an evil work isn't always executed fast or quickly, the ways of our people is just setting them to do evil. Really, the ways of mankind is setting all them to do evil. To be persecuting the Lord's people, that's evil, okay? You being the Lord's people, and you're not doing the ways that the Lord commanded you to do, that is evil, man. And as the scripture says, because judgment doesn't happen swiftly or quick, okay? You people just expect things to just go on and on and on with no repercussions, okay? But there's a cause and an effect. Because of you Israelites falling into your rebellious ways, being wicked, the effect has to be a punishment. There has to be a judgment, okay? The Lord's not unfair. He's giving you time to, you know, get yourself right, to repent, to turn back to your ways, okay? Ecclesiastes 8 and 11. Because sentence against an evil work is not executed speedily, therefore the heart of the sons of men is fully set in them to do evil. Though a sinner do evil 100 times, and his days be prolonged, yet surely I know that it shall be well with them that fear God, which fear before him. So although a sinner may commit wickedness over and over and over again, and it may feel or seem as if he's not going to ever be judged for his ways, he does so much wickedness, and the Lord being so patient, he acts as if the Lord is on his side, man. As if the Lord is just pacified and he's cool with it. But that's the deception. The Lord's patience is not to be tempted, man. Yes, the Lord is patient, but behind the Lord's patience, he has great wrath coming. And the wrath that's coming in this generation is unlike any wrath that has ever been experienced here on this earth. Never in this realm has it come to the point that it's about to come to. So because the Lord has been so patient, he's allowed man to come into this last and final generation to catch that just due, man. And this is that generation where Yahweh Shai is going to return, and everybody is going to be judged according to their works, good and evil, man. Just how it is, okay? Though a sinner do evil 100 times, his days be prolonged, yet surely I know it shall be well with them that fear God, which fear before him. So it's well for us who fear Yahweh by Hashem Yahweh Shai. Don't be deceived, because the Lord is patient, and he allows the wicked to just go on with their life as if there's no judgment for their wickedness, okay? Jump to the book of Luke. Luke 10 and 16. He that heareth you, heareth me. And he that despiseth you, despiseth me. And he that despiseth me, despiseth him that sent me. So for anyone who despises us, you despise the one you call Jesus Christ. In the Hebrew, it's Yahweh Shai. If you despise him, you despise the Heavenly Father. So many people despise God by despising the message that we bring, which is of the Lord. You're okay. Go ahead. So despising us, you despise the Lord.